Good morning, everyone. Now we come to separation of components of a mixture. Now, heterogeneous mixtures can be separated into their respective constituents by certain physical methods like sieving, we have hand picking, sedimentation, decantation, and filtration. Hand picking, you all already know. Yes, just a quick recap. Like rice grains, when we are cleaning the grains, yes, you can hand pick the stones and separate them. Yes, then sieving. A sieve is a mechanical device. Yes, it has a mesh which is attached to a frame. When we put the mixture on the sieve, the particles that are smaller than the holes of the sieve, they pass through the sieve, and the larger or the bigger particles of the mixture, they stay on the sieve. Any flour, wheat flour, like no, we can clean it or sieve it, and the larger particles will stay on the sieve. Then we come to sedimentation. Here it is actually separation of insoluble solid from a liquid. Now sedimentation also you already know about. Now like no, suppose we say take a mixture in a container of a solid and liquid. Now insoluble liquid, yes, remember. Now we keep this mixture for some time. Now you will see the insoluble substances, they settle down. Now this substances, insoluble substances that have settled down, they are called as sediments. Yes, and the liquid that collects on top, it is called as the supernatant liquid. Yes, then this supernatant liquid, this process of settling of insoluble substances in the liquid is called as sedimentation. Now, this supernatant liquid can be slowly poured into another container. This slow pouring of the supernatant liquid into another container is called as decantation. Now, sometimes the impurities are not removed by sedimentation and decantation. Then it can be followed by filtration. Now for filtration, a filter paper is used. Yes, it is folded in the shape of a cone, then it is fixed in a funnel. Yes, the mixture is made to pass through this funnel. The clear liquid collects in the beaker or the container, and the impurities, yes, or the insoluble particles, they get stuck to the filter paper. The liquid that is collected after filtration is called as filtrate, and the particles that get attached to the filter paper, yes, or trapped by the filter paper, they are called as residue. Now we come to centrifugation or churning. Now a centrifuge is a rotating device to separate a solid from a liquid. Its working principle depends upon the difference in densities of the components of the mixture to be separated. In simple words, the denser particles in the mixture, they settle down. Yes, and the lighter particles, they stay on top when the mixture is rotated at a high speed. Now a centrifuge machine, it consists of two tubes which are placed on the holder. Now the mixture, yes, is taken in these two tubes. Yes, then they are placed on the holder. Now after being placed, the centrifuge machine is rotated at a high speed. Once it is stopped, yes, then we can see that the heavier particles, they have settled down. Yes, and the lighter particles, they come on top. Now, cream can be separated from milk by this method. Even cottage cheese, that is paneer, can be separated from sour milk by the process of centrifugation. Other examples are drying off wet clothes in the washing machine and separation of blood components. Now we come to evaporation, which is again a method to separate a solid from a liquid. Yes, we use this method to separate dye from ink. Now first, let's see the arrangement. Yes, we have a beaker which is filled with water. This is the watch glass, yes, in which ink is kept. The burner to provide the heat. Yes, now once we start heating the water, yes, the heat from the water, it reaches the watch glass. Yes, now ink is a mixture of water and dye. Yes, because of the heat, yes, the water that is present in the ink, it starts getting converted into vapor. When the entire water gets evaporated or gets converted into vapor, then the dye is left. So evaporation, centrifugation and filtration are the different methods for separating solids from liquids. I hope these were clear. In case any doubts, do let me know. Thank you.